Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Lifestyle with Melanie Graves, where I share stylish and creative ideas to help you do what makes you happy in your home. Recently, I asked if you'd be interested in some information on my fitness journey this year. So today, I'm sharing exactly what I've been doing over the past few months and my favorite breakfast treat. So, like many of you, I packed on the pounds during everything that was going on last year. And in fact, I weigh more now than I did when I was 9 months pregnant with twins. And so it was really time for me to take the control back, right? And part of that was to dedicate some time to myself every day that's untouchable, even if it meant getting up a little bit early. So I ordered a Peloton. And I'd never really been in it. I've been to a spinning class maybe once or twice, but I knew I needed something that was gonna eliminate the excuses of not feeling like going to the gym or if it was raining outside, and that's what the bike did for me. So I got the bike at the end of May, and I really didn't start riding until June. And what I've been doing is a ride 6 days a week, 5 to 6 days a week for 30 minutes. And then on my off days, I'll ride 10 to 15 minutes just to kind of keep my legs moving. I was really hoping for more weight loss at this point. I've only lost about 8 pounds, but as you can see in that thumbnail picture, the weight is starting to shift. My tummy's starting to go down. My legs are feeling stronger. And so I kind of just tucked the scale away for a while because it was counterproductive with me hopping on it every day and being obsessed with the weight. So it's really more about how I'm feeling and how I'm sleeping. I'm sleeping better. And so that's all I've been doing. I really haven't even gone all in on my diet. And obviously before you start any diet and exercise routine, you'll want to consult with your doctor or a professional. I'm simply just sharing what I've been doing in case you need some ideas. So in addition to riding the 30 minutes of cardio, what makes it different in the fall is that it doesn't feel like the seventh layer of hell outside in Florida. So I can actually go outside and do a little something too. So I start my day with cardio and I finish in the evenings after dinner with a quick walk, even if it's just for 10 minutes to walk the dog around the block and get outside and get some fresh air. The other thing I've been doing, I haven't really changed my diet yet, but I'm going to be changing a few things around. But I wanted to share my breakfast option with you because I am one of those people that I don't like eggs, and so I don't eat them, and it makes it, of course the lawn crew is gonna be outside right now. So it makes it a little challenging for me to get creative and get everything that I need. So I do a protein smoothie every morning, and it's so satisfying and it's so easy. So I'm gonna share what I do. Now, a couple tricks that you probably already know, but I will mention here, is that when I'm preparing my smoothie, I use frozen fruit. And the reason why is because it makes your smoothie cold without having to add ice. I don't like ice in my smoothies. And this is the BlendTec, I think this is a Wild Side Plus. I love this blender. It actually has a smoothie feature. It takes all the guesswork out of everything for you. So in my smoothies, I start out with about 12 ounces of milk. I prefer 2%, but when I don't have 2%, the kids drink almond milk. I will use that as well because it tastes good. And then I add my fruits. So in this one, I'm gonna add frozen banana, and about half a cup of frozen strawberries. The bananas seem to die a very fast death in my house, so like right before they're about to go bad, I'll take them and peel them and freeze them, and they're perfect in the smoothies. So I put the frozen fruit in first to help it blend better. Now I'm gonna add in my protein, right? So I use, this is a plant-based protein, and the flavor is coconut macaroon. It's by True. It's a trainer that I follow. Her name is Masi Arias. And she came out with this product and I really like it. I'm kind of finicky about protein powders, but this one is good. It's got 20 grams of protein in it and 100 calories per serving. And it is plant-based. So because I use this in addition with collagen, I don't even use a whole scoop. I'll use half a scoop for 10 grams of protein. So I'm gonna add that in. And then I've recently added in, this is a grass-fed collagen peptide. This is also 20 grams per serving. It's type 1 and 3 plus probiotics. It's unflavored. It's for hair, skin, nails, and joints. I notice a huge difference when I'm using this, especially in my joints. So the one thing that I really have enjoyed about the bike is that I'm not working too hard on my joints, but I started to notice before I started riding, like my fingers would feel kind of achy in the mornings. And when I started using this, it took about 4 weeks, but I started to notice a difference. And when I'm not taking it, I notice a difference. Also, even in like the strength of my nails. So the only thing with the collagen is like, if you start taking it, you probably have to keep it up because, at least for me, I could tell a difference very, very quickly. And the collagen, a lot of people put this in their coffee. Although it's unflavored, I don't like the texture of it in my coffee. So again, a smoothie is a great place to add that. It does get sticky though, so you have to just be careful when you're adding. And then I add chia seeds. So chia seeds are really high in fiber, and they make the smoothie a lot more filling. So I add in a tablespoon of those. And then, you know, whatever your favorite fruits are. If you want blueberries, raspberries, whatever you like, put it in there. I also add a tablespoon of peanut butter because we're peanut butter fans. And sometimes I'll add about a cup of yogurt, but not today because I don't have any. And then finally, I add about a handful of spinach. Okay. Now I'm going to turn this on. And then I'll show you how beautiful everything turns out. All right. Nice thick green smoothie. Tastes amazing. The kids love it too. And it is jam-packed with all sorts of goodies. So I will sip on that this morning. Oh, and the most important thing, I almost forgot. So, so good. Now there's one more big change that I made. And that was adding in my water intake. So I ordered one of these off Amazon and I'll link it. I've always struggled, especially being on the go so much, getting enough water in. So for me, I do half of my body weight in ounces, which is basically a full one of these. And it's actually got hourly reminders. So I start at 7 and then I can kind of track my progress all day. Although I like to finish before 9 p.m. just so I'm not up using the bathroom all night. So I try to be done with my water intake by 6. But this is a game changer. They're not really convenient to carry around, but it will really help keep you on track if you struggle with staying hydrated in your water intake. So I hope this was helpful. We finished the fireplace. Next video, I'm gonna be showing you how I styled the family room for fall. And then right after that, I'm gonna take you through a step-by-step process of everything that we did to upgrade the fireplace. So until then, thank you all so much for stopping by. Please like and share this video if you got at least one new idea out of it. And until next time, love and peace.